الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله منا فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشأنه وأشهد أن محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله داعي إلى رضوانه أما بعد All thanks and praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most gracious, the most merciful. We thank Him. And as Muslims, we testify that there is none worthy of worship and praise except Allah and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final and seal of all prophets and messengers Allah sent to guide mankind from the darkness of disobedience towards the nur of Iman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us be amongst the guided ones of Kareem. My dear respectable brothers, fathers, mothers and sisters in the deen, I admonish myself standing before you and all of you to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says in the Quran, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu attaqullaha haqqa tuqatih وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ Allah said, O you who believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he ought to be feared and do not die except in the state of Islam. أَحِبَّةِ فِي اللَّهِ My dear beloved ones in the deen, إِنَّ أُمَّتَنَا مُبَعْثَرَ Our ummah, the Muslim ummah, is shattered. نعاني كثيرا من الأمراض. We are struggling from different type or kinds of diseases. And one of the major or greatest disease we are suffering from is سوء الأخلاق, bad manners, lack of manners, character, lack of good character. ومن أجل الأخلاق الحسنة أو تحقيق أهداف الأخلاق الحسنة for the purpose of achieving good manners, good character in the deen, Allah سبحانه وتعالى أرسل رسوله لينذرنا Allah سبحانه وتعالى sent His prophet to warn us and teach us as well الأخلاق, the deen. The Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم said, He said, إنما بعثت لأتمم مكارم الأخلاق. He said, I was raised and sent to you to perfect your character, manners. And also the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم said, He said, إن من أحبكم إلي وأقربكم مني مجلسا يوم القيامة. He said, The dearest and the closest of you to me on the day of judgment, أحاسنكم أخلاقا, will be those who are the best in behavior or character, manners, good etiquette, morale, good morals. إن حسن الخلق Good character, my dear brothers and sisters, هو تحلي أو تخلي عن الرذائل is to abstain from all indecency. وتحلي بالفضائل and engaged with good virtues, good character, good behavior. الخلق الحسن Good character, my dear brothers and sisters, هو أن تصل من قطعك is to connect whosoever disconnects you. Whoever disconnects you, disconnect yourself with them. وأن تعطي من حرمك and give the one who prevents you. وتعفو عن من ظلمك and to forgive whomever or whosoever oppressed you or offends you. Is to forgive them. وتوقر الكبير and you respect the elderly.
وترحم الصغير and have mercy on the younger ones. وتعطي وتعرف لكل ذي حق حقه. And to give everything and everyone its due rights. And that includes human beings, animals, and even the nature, the land, everywhere. You have to give them its due rights. الحسن الخلق أو حسن الخلق, good character, good manners, هو الإخلاص, is sincerity, والصبر, patience, والعدل, justice, والعفة, decency, or modesty, وبر الوالدين, and show kindness, respect to parents, وصلة الأرحام, and is to connect the family bond. That's good character. والرحمة, and to show mercy, وإغاثة الملحوف, and help the needy. You help the needy. والشجاعة, and courage, والكرم, generosity, والصدق, and to be truthful, والوفاء, and fulfill promises, والأمر بالمعروف, and to enjoy the good, والنهي عن المنكر, and to forbid the evil, وحسن الجوار, and to have or present good character to your neighbors, good manners, to be a good neighbor. كل هذه هو الدين. All this is the deen, is Islam. Imam Ibn Qayyim said, he said, الدين كله خلق. He said, the religion is all about character. Islam is about character. How you present yourself out there. How you behave to your brothers and sisters. How you behave to your family. How you behave to the non-Muslims. How you behave to yourself, towards your own self. This is the deen. And this is what Islam teaches myself and all of you. As Muslims, we are suffering from a disease of bad character, bad manners, lack of good manners. A brother or Muslim sister will pray his or her five daily prayers, but when it comes to the way they behave, it's contrary to Islam. The opposite of Islam. And this is not what the deen teaches us. And that's why Ibn Rajab, rahimahullah, said, he said, لَا تَتِمُ التَّقْوَى إِلَّا بِحُسْنِ الْخُلُقِ. He said, God consciousness, self-restraint, will never ever be attained or achieved except with good character. The one who possesses good character will attain taqwa Allah, God consciousness. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, according to Nawas ibn Sam'an, he said, al-birru, righteousness, husnul khuluq, is good character. Good character, that's righteousness, and that is the deen. Ahibbati fillah, my dear brothers and sisters in the deen, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَنَا فِي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا. We have the best, the greatest of all example in the life of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah confirmed that in the Quran. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهَ وَلِيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. You've got the greatest example, the greatest role model for you to follow in the life of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is your role model. Let's look at his character. Aisha radiallahu anha, the wife of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was asked. They said, someone asked Aisha radiallahu anha, saying, what was the life, or what is the life of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? His character. And then Aisha radiallahu anha, she said to the person, didn't you recite the Quran? Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. You are, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because of his character. Allah praised him. He said, you are the best in character. Manners. You are the best. He did not say you are the best of all worshippers. He did not say you are the best of all those who remember me. He said, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَذِيمٍ. You are the best in character. You possess the best of all character. And at some point, Aisha radiallahu anha, she said, كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يكون في محنة أهلي. He said the Rasul used to be at the services of his family. If he goes home, when he goes home or he comes to the house, he will serve his family. He will be at the services of his wife and his children, family. He will even cook. But today, some men, if you say to them, the wife says, can you cook for me? Oh no, what would I cook? No, that's not the sunnah. خيركم خيركم لأهلي. The Rasul said, the best of you are those who are kind to his family. Manners, good character in your house, not only in the masjid, but out there. According to Uthman radiallahu anhu, he said, إِنَّ وَاللَّهِ قَدْ سَحِبْنَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ فِي السَّفَرِ وَالْحَدَرِ وَكَانَ يَعُودُ مَرْضَانَ. He said, we accompanied the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam while he was in a journey or in the masjid or anywhere in Medina. He used to visit the sick amongst us. Show kindness to each and everyone. And that reminds me, when a man came to the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, He held the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by his neck and he said to him, Ya Muhammad, he said, give me from the wealth, the money Allah has provided you. Give it to me. And then the Sahabas, Ridwanullah alayhim, they wanted to discipline the man. He said, no, leave him. Imagine if someone comes to you now and holds you, or grab you by your neck, even and push your head, for example, and he said to me, brother, give me money. Oh, did you? Become very upset. And subhanAllah, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he wasn't upset at all. He didn't shout at the man. But rather, he gave instruction to the Sahabas to go and get whatever the man needs. And they gave it to him. When he went to Taif, the non-believers, they plotted against him. They triggered the children to turn against him. And the children, they stoned him. He was bleeding. And then the angel came to him and said, oh, you the messenger of Allah. These are the two mountains. If you would like me to take them or to leave these mountains and crush these people, I will do that now. All I want is your consent. But the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not say, take the mountains and crush them. No. He said, leave them. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will choose one amongst them or their children that will glorify Allah. So I have forgiven them. This is the deen. Good character. To forgive. And according to Jarir radiallahu anhu, he said, ما رآني رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إلا تبسم. He said, whenever the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sees me, he will smile. How many amongst the Muslims that have this good character to smile? تبسمك على وجه أخيك صدقة. When you smile to the face of your brothers and sisters, is a charity. Smile. Allah created you beautifully, mashallah. Why twist in your face all the time? Ya Habibi, when you see your family, you come home, smile. some fathers, when they enter their homes, the children go to their rooms. Everyone is scared. Why? Because the father is horrible. And this is not a deen. The Rasul, according to Aisha radiallahu anha, she said, ما ضرب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم شيئا قط. He said, the Rasul never, ever hits anything or anyone. He never hits a child. And specifically, she said here, ولا خادما ولا امرأة ولا خادما إلا أن يجاهد في سبيل الله. He said, no woman or his wife. No. The Rasul never hit his wife. And Islam did not encourage myself and any one of you to beat your wife. To hit anyone. So we have to discipline our children, our family, according to the teachings, the manners of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is Aisha giving this report. That the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never hit anyone. May the brothers and sisters in the deen. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Mu'adh, اتَّقِ اللَّهِ حَيْثُمَا كُنْتِ. He said, fear Allah wherever you are. وَأَتْبِعِ السَّيِّئَةَ الْحَسَنَةَ تَمْحُهَا. He said, and repel evil with good. You don't need to retaliate when someone, you know, hurts you. Forgive. And the one who presents to you bad character, bad manners, you show them the opposite. That's what Islam says. وَأَتْبِعُ السَّيِّئَةَ الْحَسَنَةَ تَمْحُهَا. Repel evil with good. وَخَالِقِ النَّاسِ بِخُلِقٍ حَسَنٍ. And presents good manners, good character to people. It did not say Muslims. It said human people, human beings. Muslims and non-Muslims. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to the straight path. And if we go to the Quran, there are so many ayats, verses that instruct myself and all of you to present good character. Few of them is as follow, or as follow. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, he said, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. Those who spend at the time of difficulties and fortunes. When they are happy, they receive good message or good news, or they have happy moments and times, mashallah, they spend for the sake of Allah. When they're going through difficulties as well, they spend for the sake of Allah. And Allah continues saying in the verse, وَالْكَاذِمِينَ الْغَيْثِ. And those who restrain their anger. لِأَنَّ الْغَدَبْ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ. Because anger is from shaitan. You restrain your anger. وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. And those who forgive mankind. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Allah loves those who are kind, show kindness. They forgive. They restrain their anger. Good manners. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran as well about humbleness. He said, وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَانِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنَا. He said, the servants of Allah, when they walk on the surface of the earth, they walk with humility, humble. A Muslim, you should be humble. Put yourself down. Humble yourself. Don't be arrogant. And then Allah said, وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. When the ignorance, when they face them with harsh words, with indecent words, what is the reply of those believers? They said, Salama, peace be unto you. They don't say bad words. They don't insult them because they've been insulted by the person. No. Because you are a Muslim. That's the deen. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, he said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. He said, all you who believe, اجتنبوا كثيرا من الظن. Abstain from lots or plenty of suspicion.
Don't be too suspicious.
Why? إن بعد الظن إثم. Because some of the suspicions are sins. Don't see a brother or sister standing in the night that side and then you assume he's doing something bad. No. Except if you have clear evidence. At the end of the day, we don't poke our noses into issues that do not concern us. No. Be a good Muslim with good character. Subhanallah. Islam is so beautiful. Allah said, اجتنبوا كثيرا من الظن. إن بعد الظن إثم. Abstain from plenty of suspicions. Because some of them are sins. ولا تجسسوا. And do not spy at each other. If someone is hiding himself from you, for you not to see him or her, don't send watch into their places. Try to disgrace them. Try to expose them. Except if that person is a danger in the community or the society, then you have to. But help them. Allah said, "Wala tajassasu." Do not spy at each other. "Wala yaghtab ba'dukum ba'da." And do not backbite. Wow. This is what's happening today. We have grudges against ourselves, brothers, Muslims, against a Muslim. Could you imagine? Talking about that brother, ill speech about the brother or the sister. No. Don't backbite them because this is not allowed in the deen. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talk about another character which is very, very important. Allah said, وَلَا تَقْتُلُ النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ. Do not kill innocent soul. It's not allowed in the deen. In another ayah, anyone who kills an innocent soul, the reward is equivalent as if you've killed the entire mankind. Entire mankind. You will not give that person life. يوم القيامة. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive each and every one of us. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعه بالإحسان إلى يوم الدين. We thank Allah and the peace and blessings be upon the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and to those who follow his footsteps until the day of the resurrection. Brothers and sisters in the deen, الخلق الحسن, good character, muhim, is very, very important for mujtama, in the community. And especially our youth. If the youth lack good manners, good character, then there is no future for the ummah. And that's what we are suffering from. And it said, فَاقِدُ شَيْءٍ لَا يُعْدِي. He who does not possess or have will not give. If I don't have money, how can I provide money? And the problem in our society, our communities, or the Muslim ummah is we don't have role models. Why? Because we do not follow the teachings, the practices of the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we did not choose that path to be our path. We did not choose the Rasul to be our role model. If you have a role model, then you have someone, you have something as well to pass on to your children. They learn from you. The children, they look at you, how you behave to their mothers or their fathers, how you behave out there, how you behave in the masjid, the way you talk, if you tell lies or not. They learn from you. You don't need to tell them, say this or say that. But they look at the way you behave and they put that into practice. When we lack that value, those values, then here comes the problem in our society. And this is what we are facing now because of character. Muslims,
We need to come together.
We need to make sure
we follow the Quran and Sunnah and teach
our family,
brothers and sisters, as well as the children,
the true picture of this deen. According to Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu,
he said, "Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam," the Messenger of Allah said, he said, "Akthar ma yudkhilu al-jannah
taqwa Allah wa husn al-khuluq." He said, "The fear of Allah
and good morals,
good character, akhlaq,
are the two major characteristics which lead to paradise. The fear of Allah and good character."
And in another hadith, according to Abu Darda radiallahu anhu,
he said, "Ma min shay'in fil mizan athqal min husn al-khuluq."
He said, "There is nothing
which is heavier on the scale yawm al-qiyamah than good character." Subhanallah.
Good manners. Very, very important.
So, my dear brothers and sisters in the deen,
when we go out there,
let's portray the true picture of this deen.
And let's fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive each and every one of us. Those who are sick amongst us, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cure them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to the straight path and grant us the best of all character. ربنا اغفر لنا وارحمنا واسترنا واعف عنا وتجاوز عن سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الابرار اللهم تب علينا توبه نصوحا ربنا ظلمنا انفسنا وان لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكن من الخاسرين اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا واسترنا واعف عنا يا الله اللهم نسالك ان لا تجعلنا في مقامنا هذا ذنبا الا غفرته ولا عيبا الا سترته ولا هما الا فرجته ولا دينا الا قضيته ولا مريضا الا شفيته ولا ظالمين الا هديته نسالك ان ترفع مكتك وغضبك عنا ولا تؤاخذنا بما فعلنا ولا تؤاخذنا بما فعل أسفوا منا وصلوا مع سيدنا محمد قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.